Hi everyone, my name is Dodge Gitachu. In this video we will learn about the definition, branches, scope, approaches, and themes of geography. I have tried to make the presentation short and simple to understand. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe my channel. Could you write more comprehensive definition of geography? Due to the dynamic and multidisciplinary nature of geography, there is no universally accepted single definition. Most people perceive that geography is simple recognition of facts, knowing about place names, mentioning countries with their respective capital cities, map making, and/or map reading. Some others have been intensively utilizing the traditional definition, which is description of the Earth. Likewise, television and radio question and answer programs ask participants geography questions like, capital cities of different countries, the most populated cities of the world, the highest mountain in the world, the largest river in the world, the deepest lake in Ethiopia, etc. And if a person is good in responding to such kind of questions, he or she will be considered as good in the field of geography. However, geography is much beyond mere memorization of facts. We can define geography in a more comprehensive way as a science which deals with the spatio-temporal variation, interaction, and distribution of various geographic phenomena over the Earth's surface. Branches of geography. Let's proceed to the next topic, branches of geography. Broadly, the branches of geography can be grouped into three: physical geography, human geography, and technical geography. Physical geography. As the name implies, physical geography deals with the natural environment including plant and animals. Subfields include geomorphology, pedology, hydrology, climatology, natural resource management, etc. Human geography. Human geography is also known as anthropogeography. It studies about the interaction and interrelation of humans among themselves and with their environment. Courses include cultural and social geography, political geography, urban and regional planning, geography of tourism and development, geography of transport and development, etc. Technical geography. Following the advancement of technology, this branch of geography has become vital for all the other geography branches. It is software-based spatial analysis of both the human and physical geography. Courses include geographic information system, remote sensing, surveying, quantitative techniques and spatial analysis, cartography and map reading, etc. Besides, there have been other integrated and overlapping courses composed of both human and physical geography. The scope of geography is as wide as its focus areas. It includes four major components: lithosphere, hydrosphere, biosphere, and atmosphere. Lithosphere refers to the hard and rigid part of the Earth which extends up to 100 kilometers from the upper part of the crust to the uppermost solid mantle. The lithosphere can be classified as oceanic lithosphere and continental lithosphere. Oceanic lithosphere is related with oceanic crust and found in oceanic basins. Whereas, continental lithosphere is associated with continental crust. The second component, hydrosphere, focuses on water body which can be rivers, seas, lakes, oceans and related. The third component, biosphere, includes all living things including humans. The interaction of humans and animals among themselves and with their environment studied within biosphere scope. The fourth component is the atmosphere, which is composed of four major layers below the interplanetary space. Therefore, the scope of geography is the interface of lithosphere, hydrosphere, biosphere, and atmosphere. In other words, it extends from the Earth's surface up to the uppermost boundary of the last layer of the atmosphere. We can say, within this scope, geography studies about all the aforementioned topics both in space and time. Approaches of geography. Geography can be approached by considering two continuums, a human physical continuum and a topical regional continuum. Let's discuss the topical regional continuum, or the topical regional geography. Topical or systematic geography view particular categories of physical or human phenomena as distributed over the Earth. It is also called general geography. For example, if we study types of climate across Europe, Asia, and Africa, it is topical geography. On the other hand, regional geography is concerned with the associations within regions of all or some of the elements and their interrelationships. It is also known as special geography. According to Hartshorne, regional geography is the study of all the features of a given region, any two-dimensional area of interest. For example, if we take a particular region, let's say Africa, and study the landform, climate, demography, vegetation, etc., it is regional geography. Following quantitative revolution, regional approach has become less popular. And, practically, there is a strong interdependence and overlapping of systematic and regional approach. Themes of geography. Geography has five basic themes, namely location, place, human environment interaction, movement, and region. Location. Location is defined as a particular place or position which can be expressed either with reference to another place which is called relative location, or latitudes and longitudes which is called absolute location. Place. Place refers to the physical and human aspects of a location. It is a way of seeing, knowing, and understanding the world. This theme of geography is associated with toponym, site, and situation. Toponym denotes the name of a place. Site refers to the description of the features of the place. It is about the internal features of the place, and situation refers to the environmental conditions of the place. It gives a detailed explanation regarding the surrounding environment. Each place in the world has its unique characteristics expressed in terms of physical and human landscape. Let's have an example. Can you explain your university as a place? Let's assume you are a student of Debrecen University. How do you tell your place for someone who doesn't know even the town? Here, the toponym is Debrecen University. The site is mentioning different features within the university, both human and natural features, such as postgraduate building, admin block, students' dormitory, stadium, open spaces, and greeneries, etc. Whereas, the situation is explaining the surrounding environment. In case of Debrecen University, it is within Kebil 09, there is Beresa River in the north side of the university, the main road to Addis Ababa in the west side, etc. Hence, place is the integration of the three dimensions. Human-environment interaction. Human-environment interaction involves three distinct aspects: dependency, adaptation, and modification. Dependency refers to the ways in which humans are dependent on nature for a living. For example, air, water, and other natural resources. Adaptation relates to how humans modify themselves, their lifestyles, and their behavior to live in a new environment with new challenges. For example, the use of umbrella during rain or sunny days, wearing thick or warm clothes during cold days, developing traditional and environmental friendly methods to live in harmony with nature. In general, it involves adjusting ourselves in accordance with the environment. The final dimension is modification. Modification allowed humans to conquer the world for their comfortable living. In this case, humans modify or change the environment. With the advancement of technology, humans have been able to change hostile environments to livable one. We can take one of the most beautiful and recently developed cities of the world, Dubai, as an example. The development of the city could have been null without the technological advancement. The city flourished in the hostile environment with intensive modification and changing of the environment. They are able to set up a settlement and all man-made islands. Let's enjoy this short video, Environmental Modification. Thank you. In general, they converted the most hostile environment to one of the best places to live in the Middle East. Moreover, nowadays, artificial rainfall has become normal via cloud seeding technology. Hence, weather modification paved the way to enjoy rainfall in arid and semi-arid areas. Movement. Movement entails to the translocation of human beings, their goods, and their ideas from one place to another. The physical movement of people allowed the human race to inhabit all the continents and islands of the world. Another aspect of movement is the transport of goods from one place on the earth to another. The third dimension of movement is the flow of ideas that allows the unification of the human civilization and promotes its growth and prosperity. Thus, people and objects involve physical movement while ideas can flow from one place to another in a moment via different media. For example, internet. Region. Region is a geographic area having distinctive characteristics that distinguishes itself from adjacent units of space. There are two types of region, formal and functional. Formal region is characterized by homogeneity in terms of a certain phenomenon, such as soil, temperature, rainfall, or other cultural elements like language, religion, gender, and ethnicity. As an example, we can mention the different administrative regions of Ethiopia or from the physical aspect, Daga, Kola, or Berha regions. When we see functional or nodal region, it is characterized by functional interrelationships in a spatial system defined by the linkages binding particular phenomena. It is based on economic activity. In relative speaking, a given place has one or more economic base by which the dominant economic activity or source of income serve as a criteria. Some areas have a special function within primary, secondary, tertiary, and or quaternary economic activities. For example, coffee-producing region, banana-producing region, fish-producing region, coal-producing region, industrial region, fashion city or region, tourism-dominated region, etc. The functional region is more subjective and has fluid or overlapping boundary. Generally, in one way or another, geography focuses in these five basic themes.